The possibility of regulating traditional and alternative medicine and its practitioners being discussed in the Philippine Senate. ABS-CBN correspondent Katrina Domingo now joins us for more details. Kat?
Denise, a Senate panel discussed the possibility of regulating traditional and alternative medicine and its practitioners as hospitals in the country remain nearly full due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Among the options raised during the hearing this morning are to create licenses for traditional healthcare practitioners or issue certifications for small-time providers in rural communities. The Philippine Institute of Traditional and Alternative Healthcare, or PITAC, says there is a need to regulate manghihilots, albularios, or so-called folk healers, as well as acupuncturists and other traditional medicine providers to ensure that the public is protected from fly-by-night and unregistered practitioners. This after a profiling study showed that while there are 2,691 traditional medicine practitioners in four provinces in the Philippines, only 1,479 are registered nationwide with the government. PITAC says this implies that a lot of unregistered practitioners may not have come up with the knowledge and skills required by the competent standards and guidelines for the accredited modality, which poses a big risk to the community. The Food and Drug Administration says it only has the authority to regulate all health products, including traditional medicine and herbal products, but it is not authorized to regulate the practitioners and the practice of traditional medicine. Now, Denise, while the Department of Health and several senators backed the approval of Senate Bills number 1308 and 2127, which authorizes the government to regulate the traditional medicine industry, lawmakers have yet to finalize its discussion on how the regulation would be carried out. If we recall, last year, the national government said it was keen on tapping herbal medicine as a possible supplemental treatment for COVID-19, with three clinical trials underway. Denise?
Thank you, Kat.